Epigenetics, regulating life. Even the grandchildren of people who have suffered starvation have an increased tendency to be overweight. How can this happen? This is Iris. Iris was pregnant when she lived through the Dutch famine of 1944, the Hunger Winter. We're going to take a look at what it did to her DNA. These are Iris's stem cells. Stem cells are cells that reproduce themselves by division, on the one hand, and form a differentiated cell, such as a muscle cell, on the other. The genetic information is stored in them on the DNA. In human beings, the DNA is distributed among 46 chromosomes, which are X-shaped structures. In the chromosomes, the DNA is in the form of a chromatin fiber, which is wrapped around protein coils known as histones. Let's take a closer look at the histones. Each histone has small tails. These serve as docking sites. 8 histones in combination with the DNA strand form a nucleosome. Methyl groups can bind to the ends of the histones. These consist of 1 carbon atom and 3 hydrogen atoms. Bound methyl groups prevent a gene from being read by specialized enzymes. In effect, they switch off the gene. If a histone has no methyl groups, the DNA sequence wrapped around it is active and thus readable. External factors such as the starvation that Iris experienced also cause methyl groups to bond directly to or decouple from the DNA. This usually happens at CpG islands, which are regions of the DNA that contain high proportions of the nucleobases cytosine and guanine. But what does this mean for the next generations? The number and distribution of the methyl groups on the DNA give rise to a very characteristic methylation pattern, the epigenome or methylome. This is unique for every individual. The epigenetic imprinting can be transferred to the individual's descendants. Because Iris had to suffer starvation, her body utilized food especially efficiently. This can cause an increased tendency to be overweight even 2 generations later. Iris was pregnant during the famine, and the methylization resulted in the unborn child also utilizing food especially efficiently and having a normal birth weight. The child also passed on these properties to his descendants so that they tend to be overweight when there is a good supply of food. The granddaughter also has an increased risk of excess weight and heart disease. So even the grandchildren suffer the consequences of a traumatic experience that the grandmother lived through.
Evonik, leading beyond chemistry.